Myoglobin?
That was the word of yesterday.
That was yesterday?
Myoglobin.
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 Yeah, it's in the red meat.
Yeah.
And in your body when it gets injured.
Yeah, it's an iron group that holds on to oxygen, only one oxygen. Hemoglobin holds on to four. And if you take that and you cook your meat, it's injured, it'll come out of there, it'll be kind of a pinkish color. But if you overcook it, the iron in there changes from +2 to +3. It turns into a gray kind of thing. So
when you cook it out.
Yeah, if you overcook the meat, then all of a sudden it goes from +2 to +3. And you see that with hematite, which is like a kind of a bright brown iron rust, and then a darker iron rust would be stuff with a +3 in it. That'll be kind of a black, or like a magnetite. So what they'll do, they're starting to treat meat now with carbon monoxide. So when you grill meat, there'll be carbon monoxide, and that'll lock in a pink color forever. Because it locks in there, and it's like you get carbon monoxide poisoning. It's like you can't get oxygen at your hemoglobin because it's such a tight bond where the oxygen comes and goes. The carbon monoxide stays for a long time. So they're starting to treat meat with that carbon monoxide. So it's pink. People think, that must be good.
Wow. Well, thanks for the lesson of the day. Yeah, that's I want you to repeat that, Larry. So, everything he said. But the oxygen, how many oxygen does myoglobin have? No.
Myoglobin?
Yeah.
Is one.
What?
Yep. Yeah. And hemoglobin?
Is four.
Four.
And it attaches. And when it, what does the carbon monoxide do?
It locks it in. Yeah, locks it in and keeps it from absorbing oxygen.
Yeah. And I like that about the rust, too.
Yeah, that's interesting, too.
So we're going to.